Well, welcome back to Muscle Car Madness Garage. Now, today, what we're going to do on this episode is we're going to go through a checklist. You know, I live my life by the check boxes, you know, just list, check them off one day at a time, one thing at a time, one task at a time. Now, this car here, a lot of tasks, a lot of episodes, a lot of, you know, this is going to be months out, I think. Hopefully, not too long, but I'm going to be working on the car every day. And hopefully I get a lot of stuff done, but some of the stuff I'm not going to do myself. I can't do the stuff by myself. So that's what I want to go with you all today. Things that I'm going to attempt to take care of, things that are going to be sent out, which is going to go by the list. And then what I'm going to look for are your comments to let me know, hey, you know, you're missing something or you forgot this or whatever. So let's go to the board now, and I'm going to go through the list with you right now. All right, so here's my list. So let's start right up here at the very top. We're going to pray every day to get this done, that's for sure. We're going to start, obviously, with the drivetrain. And what I'm going to do is the engine is gone. I'm simply going to take out the engine and the transmission. Obviously, I'm going to separate the two. And I'm going to send the engine out into a shop that does that kind of work, have them check the block, have them check the heads, make sure that everything is, there's no cracks in it, and then just go through it, you know, and just make sure that they're in good shape. Transmission, same thing. I'm going to send it out to a transmission shop, just have them rebuild the whole thing, bearings, the whole thing. And then on the differential, I may not have to do anything with that other than change the fluid and the gasket around it. I'll have to check with that. You know, I know I'm leaving out the drive shaft here. I'll replace all the U-joints and all that at that time. Second is the cooling system here. As you can see, that's, you know, that's the original radiator. There's not much doubt there. So I am going to upgrade the radiator into a more efficient one, and then obviously change all the hoses and do that while the engine is out. On the fuel system, the tank, I did smell some gases, so I'm gonna make sure that get rid of that old gas, and hopefully I don't have to change that tank. I might just be able to clean it out. I think it'll obviously have to come out, and then I'll make a determination at that point, and then I'll change all the lines as well. On the braking system, the master cylinder replaced, changed, probably upgraded to a more efficient one. That's going to include all of the brake lines. I'm going to do all the rotor work, and there'll be replacements. They'll just be upgraded. And if the old ones are still usable, fine. But I'm not going to make this vehicle into an all disc thing. It's going to stay the way it was. I'll just change all the pads and the drums at that time. On the suspension, I am going to do the front and rear shocks. They'll be obviously upgraded. And then that's it on the suspension. Now, this also includes all of the tie rods and everything else up front. Now, I'm thinking about doing some upgrades because I know there are some kits out there that you can upgrade the suspension on these cars. But I want to try to keep it as original as possible. If the old parts are still usable, perhaps. But I think, you know, for the safety aspects, I'm going to do some upgrades on that. The electrical is, I'm not 100% sure. Obviously, the alternator and the solenoids, all those things will be replaced. And my hope is that, you know, the keys and the ignition all still work. I don't know. I'm going to have to go through all that. But the alternator, all those things, the starter, those will all be replaced brand new when the engine is put back in place. So I'm not 100% sure where we're going to go with electrical, but that's everything to do with the interior. On the body, obviously, there's going to be a lot of work there. I'm either going to replace the panels. I'm going to repair them if they can be repaired, I'll do that. And as far as the floor, that one little hole in the floor, that's got to be repaired. A little cut out there, welded back in. The trunk, same thing. That whole thing's got to come out. That's why that is going to fall right into place with the tank here. So while the floor is out, might as well take the tank out as well. And then do that undercoating. You remember the video I showed you that had the walnut shells. So I'm going to clean that whole thing while I'm taking all those pieces apart, and then just do the undercoat, that, you know, that undercoating spray at that time. Big one here on the paint, block and sand, filler first, obviously, block and sand, color, clear, and then finally on the decals. I have a portable paint booth here. I can place it here on my property. So I was thinking about just doing it piece by piece, doing the doors, doing the trunk. I'm not sure if I can take off all the panels, but, you know, just doing it piece by piece if that's the smart way to do it. In the interior, it's fairly simple, just repair and replace. I mean, I've got all the pieces. Everything is here. I'm not going to replace, as you saw, I'll replace some of the carpeting, but, I mean, the seats will just need to be cleaned, and some of it, I just don't think the seats need to be replaced, but everything, there'll be some repair, obviously, on the interior, but I think everything else is in place and ready to go. And, you know, one thing I left off on here, this part up here, is which is part of the interior, is that shifter. You know, I've got to make sure that, I'm fairly sure that is the original shifter, and but, you know, I'm fairly sure it is, but that's obviously going to have to be replaced as part of the interior as well. And then finally, we're going to do the reassemble. My hope is that in a, you know, few weeks, couple of months, I get the engine back and just simply put the thing back in like where it belongs, along with the proper hood, and everything else is ready to go. So there it is. There's my checklist, the to-do list, if you would, of this 72 Mach 1. So I'm looking forward to hearing you guys' comments, and what am I missing? This is pretty much in order, other than that interior that might, you know, go up. I'm not sure when I'm going to do that interior work, whether it needs to be before paint and body. I'm not sure, but, you know, this is a huge job. I'm not sure it's going to matter that much, but nevertheless, let me know what you think and if I've missed anything, and I look forward to hearing what you got to say. So what we're going to do first thing is we're going to take off the hood, me and Terrell. So here we go. Let's do it. Well, fellas, there you go. You see it. Just an old, I don't know. It looks like it's a 72, but it's green. That's obvious. And it got a lot of rust inside it. When we put it down, anyway, it had a lot of rust moving around, as you can see right there. Yeah. But this is not the hood that we're going to be using on the Mach 1. The one we're going to be using is sitting right over here, and I'll show you that later on. So there we go. A little better view now of the 351 high output engine. And within the next couple, 3 days, this sucker's coming out. I'm gonna remove the doors. I'm gonna remove that old trunk that you saw. The hood is already gone. You knew that already. And then I'm going to drain all the fluids out. I don't think there's any gas left. I hope not, but if there is, it's gone. And then engine, obviously, transmission or engine oil, transmission fluid, and anything in the radiator, that is gone. So I'm going to prep the engine, get the fluids all out, and then over the next day or so, I'm gonna get everything ready to go, plop this engine right out of the old Mach 1. So let's get cracking. So we're gonna start with this door. And as you have already seen, it's gonna take a little work here. I may just replace that whole unit right there, probably will. But in the meantime, this old door, We're going to come off with it right there. You see them bolts? Let's see, right here and here. And then there and there. And there's two more down in here. And that'll take this door off. Now, I'm going to need Terrell's help, I think. I'm going to put a jack underneath the door there. Hold that up. So I think that's what I'm going to do right now. Here's what I'm seeing right here. There were the two bolts that were right here. They're gone. And then there were two bolts that were here, right up in here. And they're gone, as you can see. Even though there's three holes, there were only two bolts, which is interesting. Yeah, there were only two bolts, but there were three holes. Yeah, there's only, yeah, because there's only three or two bolt holes underneath that hinge. And I got those two now. There's one there, and I'm assuming there's another one, you know, in the back there. That frame rail looks pretty good. And this can clean up, as you can tell. That can clean up no problem. There's a little rust right there. These are coming off anyway. And I'm going to redo them. But that looks pretty good. That right there has got to be replaced or repaired. That little piece right there. That rocker looks pretty good. That, of course, is going to be replaced right there. Everything else is looking all right. Now let's take a look at that door.
He said get some gloves if you need them.
Yeah. Delicate hands and Terrell. So this obviously will be all scraped off here, as you can see. This right here, what do you guys think?
Oh crap.
Well, we're gonna you know, obviously, is that something that can be repaired, a little J-weld, or does this whole inner door or the whole door need to be replaced? I hate to do that. I'd love to be able just to repair this thing.
But there's a will, there's a way.
Well, let's, you know, I want to try to keep as many of the parts on it as possible. Original parts. Okay. Yeah. So on this door, since we don't have a lot of room, and we got some door cards right there, I'm going to move on the back side. I'm going to move it out as well. I'll move these two cards out of the way, and I think that'll give me enough room to get this door off, to get this door off too. So here we go. These are door cards. I don't think they came with this car, quite honestly. But there's some extra parts that maybe I can use that carpet or those inserts. You know, I'm not 100% sure. I really don't know. But the guy that I bought the car from, he had built two other Mach 1s. And so these were cards, I think, from an extra Mach 1. Now, this is that hood I was telling y'all about that's going on this car. Now, this is a flat black hood without any decals. You know, the stencil. And my thoughts are that I'm thinking about cleaning it up and leaving it and or painting it just flat black, leaving it just like it is. That might be a different deal right there, so we'll have to see. And look at that seam right there. Can you see that seam right there? Yeah, that might be something we may have to grind that down, see what's under there. But if I'm not mistaken, doesn't that quarter panel seam up right there? I think so. Anyway, let me get in here now on this side. And I'm going to push it out this way a little bit. If I can't. Yeah. There we go. It gives me a little bit more room. All right. Okay, that was success. Again, looking in the inner fender there, it looks good. I think this all looks really good. Just dirty, old. This is the one I was telling you guys about. There's definitely a hole right in here. And I knew about that, but until I get this carpet out of here, I'm going to have to either replace this whole thing when I get the carpet out, or just patch it up. You know, we'll figure it out at that time. But next part of this puzzle, I'm going to take this fender off, and obviously bolt there, bolts up front, fenders are coming off here very soon as well. So let's take a look at this other door. About that myself. All right, so here we go. Same deal. As you can see, skin rust here. And this one, it's got that, I guess that's where that water came down on those Mustangs after all them years. Just settled right in there. So gonna have to be replaced. Either this, the inner skin, you know, where it was welded here, and on this side looks pretty good. I just don't want to replace these doors, you know, I really don't. There's something going on right here. Can you see how, I don't know, maybe that's been patched up before, I don't know. But everything else looks decent, you know. Just needs to be cleaned up, period. All right, now let's start in on this trunk lid. Obviously, this is going to be, I'm just going to take them bolts off there, them bolts off there. And later on, I'll take the wing off right there. I think the bolts are under here for that. Yeah, right there and there. So for now, I'm just going to take this off. Again, lighten up the load on the old Mach 1. All right. Look at that thing.
I think not, Ricky. I think not.
All right. Let's see if we can get this light out. I think this obviously has got to be replaced right in here. As you can see. And this being the gas tank, which looks at this moment, it looks okay. But obviously there's big holes down here. But I'm thinking this whole area right here is going to have to be, you know, obviously it's going to have to be replaced. And here as well. So there you have it. Appreciate you stopping in the garage at Musclecar Man's Garage. I'll see you next time. Thank you.